The first night of Seasonal Disorder. Please welcome your host, Kate Sines.
Tipperville, or how small, population-wise?
3,000.
3,000 people?
Got it.
What is, like, the town dish of Tipperville?
Somebody didn't lock the duck pen again.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. Duck pen's open.
It was Jenny.
Jenny.
Definitely it was Jenny.
It's great we hired the CSI guy from the big city.
Yeah, you know, I'm really trying to get in the accent here, you know, really get into Tipperville, really understand how everyone thinks, you know? You've got to understand what's going through your heads. You've got to understand the people here, you know? Right, Cindy?
Oh, yeah.
Carolyn? You know?
It's all getting in the head of the ducks, I guess.
You know?
You all are too fancy for me. This is a... This life that you live, this isn't the life I thought. I thought I would just be sitting on the duck bed, raising the ducks. Mending the ducks.
The big question is, if you got no ducks, how are you gonna make those pillows that you promised your kids for Christmas? About those
kids, I'm sorry. I didn't get your Christmas presents this year. There's no money. Love's what? Enough, right? You love me enough.
No. 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 We need presents.
We need presents. Mom, I'm tired. I haven't slept in days. I need pillows.
Mom, we told you this was the last Christmas that we were gonna stand for no presents.
sorry, but we are trying to instill good values in you. Your father and I, we didn't grow up with much. We turned out fine.
I just want to sleep on a pillow, Mom. I'm tired of laying down on piles of rocks.
Your father doesn't make pillow money, Jerry. He doesn't make pillow money. We make rock pile money.
I'm not gonna love you anymore. I'm just not. I can't go through another Christmas like
this. We can't do it.
Can't do it.
I thought we at least made love money.
So you gotta tell us a little bit more about this duck, you know? Oh. I didn't quit my big CSI job to come down here and be a duck investigator for nothing.
Well, it's not just one duck. It's two. They walk in pairs. They like to waddle together. They waddle around. They usually wander around the pen. We've never had issue. But now they're out.
Sheila, thanks for coming. God, it took you long enough. All the ducks are gone.
Sheila. Our duck farm. The ducks have left.
So?
Sheila, what kind of farmhand are you? You don't care about anything.
I mean, they come back every summer.
You know what?
What?
I changed my mind. It wasn't Jenny who left this gate open. I think it was Sheila.
Sheila, I'll pay you good money.
I licked that piece of dirt right there, and it tasted as if your scent had not closed the gate. That's all the evidence we need, okay?
Purely circumstantial.
We convict on circumstantial evidence.
What does Mr. CIA have to say to us?
Where were you last night? I've been with this woman for like 1 hour, and she's been able to tell me where everyone's been in this town based on dirt samples.
The dog of dirt.
She's been licking dirt for like 35 years now. Everything.
I think we're gonna need you to tell the murderer just on the dirt sample. Can you do it?
Just give me. Prepare myself.
5 years at police academy for this.
Dan Brown.
God damn it, she's a genius. Sheila, I can't believe you.
What do you mean?
We have an expert dirt licker here who says that you have let the ducks out of this duck farm.
That's the problem. You keep on trusting the dirt licker person. It doesn't even matter.
It does matter.
They don't know everything. 35 years. Fooey, okay? How
dare you spit on my good name? How dare you spit on it?
I'll fooey again. Okay? Fooey!
Sheila, we don't use that kind of language here. That's not what Timberville is about.
I need to go cool off.
Sheila, look. I'm willing to trust you. You gotta tell me where you were last night, though.
Okay, you seem very trustworthy and not really to rat me out. So, I might have took a...
Answer honestly, Sheila.
Oh, they're home alone.
Lies! I can't hold my tongue anymore. You know what? I don't need to lift dirt. I know you didn't close that pen. Because I was here last night, too. And I saw you not do it.
Why did you not just say that?
I'm known as the dirt expert. I want to keep up my reputation.
You wanted to confess.
And you didn't.
I didn't confess because I wasn't there. I was at home alone. So that's why. Circumstantial evidence. I know y'all get with that around here. I mean, but
come on.
What's the penalty here? I mean, what do I get? Jail the clock, yo.
Sheila Johnson, have these ducks, I sentence you to exile.
Really?
You have bankrupted this town. You have ruined our good name. We have no pillows to give our children.
Come on. It's a little harsh.
Now hold up. We're in Tipperville. We don't have that many people. Firing everyone that lets our ducks out or steals things or, you know, disobeys the law. We're not a big city. We're not like a Toledo. We're Tipperville. I can't lose Sheila like that. Now you're not off the hook.
Oh, a lesser punishment would be, appropriate for these circumstances. It sounds a little much, you know. I don't mind doing a little community service, you know, helping old people. I don't think it ain't nothing. Yeah. Hey, community service, helping old people, huh? Hey, all right! I got you, that's a deal. Oh, no.
You know the law in Tipperville? The sentence has been laid, and it must be carried out. So if you're not getting exiled, I guess you better pick somebody who is getting exiled.
Oh, dear.
And you're the only other one in this court, so.
This is not what I bargained for.
None of the other 2,997 people decided to show up to this case.
Sheila, you've been a great farm hand.
Really?
Yeah, but not that good. If one of us has got to go, it's got to be you. These are Tipperville laws.
Fine. I see what you're doing. We'll have a staring contest to decide it. And that is also the law.
I will judge.
You know these two ducks are important. The whole town relies on them. If they're gone, then we're screwed. They're the two largest ducks in Tipperville. People from all over Tipperville come to see these ducks. How this economy works, from what I understand.
Yes, we're right. We rely on ducks. Not like the Aflac duck, but like real ducks.
Which we now don't have because somebody didn't close the
shoot!
Y'all spending all this time accusing me of these crimes. Why y'all look for the ducks? Huh? Why didn't even try? I mean, they could be across the river. Hey, y'all even looked?
Just that river is great.
So much better than Tipperville.
Ripperville is so much better than Tipperville. Hey, do you hear they have like a Toledo population?
I did not, but that is amazing.
I'm going to enjoy our new life here.
Plus, we'll probably be famous because we're hopping ducks.
Yeah, we're hopping ducks. We're like Bonnie and Clyde ducks.
You think they're in Riverdale? That's like Toledo. Nobody wants to go to Toledo.
I was just making a suggestion. I'm just saying, let's split the, you know, get the focus away from crimes and let's get a solution, okay? We have a problem.
Look, here's the thing. I know you have quite a bit of evidence that I did murder those people, but I think we should look away from crime. You know, there are other problems in the world. You know, this is one murder. It's one murder.
There's a lot of things that are going wrong on this planet.
Yeah.
Like why Jeannie won't call me back. I've got other things to worry about besides your murders.
Let's think about that. Let's think about why Jeannie won't call you back. Let's put these murders behind us. Look away from the crime. Look away.
I'm just saying, if we find these damn ducks, you know, who cares how they got out or who let them out, okay? Because it really doesn't matter. So when we find this, the person who finds them is going to be a hero.
Sheila's right. We need to stick together, save this town.
You son of a gun.
What?
Over here talking about heroes. You know what? I bet you left this gate open so that you can
here leave
this party
the
and find
these
damn jumping ducks yourself and then be crowned the Christmas Queen of Tipperville.
Listen.
I see your plan.
You do? Is that transparent?
Yes.
It's not that transparent. Okay? You don't know. I'm trying to find the ducks. I'm trying to. We only have the two ducks, right? Let's stop this. Let's go. Come on.
Sheila.
Come on, everybody. Let's go.
Sheila.
Come on.
I'm done.
Okay.
I'm done, Sheila. Sheila, you have put this town economy to hell with the ducks. This is about a personal relationship here. What's more important than love? It's almost Christmas time. I feel like my heart's been broken.
Wait a second, I did not come down here to Timberville. Quit my job at the CSI and the CIA. And not find these ducks. We're finding these ducks.
Yeah!
I don't see how we're gonna find them at this point. Tell me, are we gonna find these ducks? Are we gonna save my relationship with my farmhand and the only other person in Timberville I ever talked to? Because we are a very small population and we don't get out very often.
Relationship with your farmhand? New development.
It is platonic. It is platonic.
So,
you're the only other person that I really talked to in Timberville, and
yeah.
We live together on a farm.
Mm-hmm.
You're my farmhand.
I am. I got the
farmhand. Nice farmhand. I could get used to this, but don't we have to? Isn't there in the movies they say something about filing with HR? We don't have that.
This is all
This is feeling very platonic. You know, platonic people definitely give each other massages, and farmhands use their farmhands for platonic things. Platonic feels good. It's platonic. It is completely platonic.
I don't know about that.
I want my ducks back and I want my friend back, but I feel hopeless, so I feel like giving up the whole thing. Maybe Riverdale, shit, I don't know. I'm a mess.
You've been in this all your entire life, I get it. You never crossed the river.
What do you think, dirt-looking expert?
We have to do it.
All right, Sheila.
Don't act like this was your idea. I know it was, but...
We're modest in Timberville. You don't have to take all the credit.
Yeah, that's a good effort. Yeah.
Exactly.
All right, so we need to get the most sophisticated technological equipment to locate these ducks. Now, I don't know any kind of organization or agency that would have this this kind of equipment here at Timberland. Who would have this?
I don't know. Who from the big city would have this?
Yeah, who let us use it for free?
That's a good question.
The CIA.